Golf courses are a living collection of turf grasses, trees, and landscape plants. They benefit golfers, communities, and wildlife by providing habitat, open space, and recreational opportunities. But they aren't meant to be perfectly uniform green spaces. Golf course superintendents strive to maintain healthy, uniform turf with good playing conditions, but there are a lot of stresses that can cause the turf to look a little different. Non-living stress factors like shade, drought, and cart traffic, along with a number of pests, can all affect turf appearance. Some pests can be seen with the naked eye, while others require a microscope and expert diagnosis. Regardless of the pests, superintendents leverage integrated pest management strategies to sustainably manage pest populations. These strategies rely on developing acceptable levels of turf stress before any action to control them is taken.
Well, if we do find we have a pest, we don't go out and treat the whole golf course. We actually go out and treat just the spot, and we do that according to the label.
Superintendents actively scout and sample to monitor pest activity. They also study individual pest life cycles and research a variety of control measures so that when pest control is warranted, it is targeted and conducted with minimal economic and environmental impact. Sometimes alleviating pest pressure and promoting turf recovery requires tactics that may temporarily disrupt play quality. One of the best means of alleviating turf stress is to raise the mowing height. This integrated pest management strategy may cause a temporary reduction in green speed.
The golf course is our most important asset. The long-term benefits far outweigh any short-term inconveniences.
So the next time you're out on the golf course, remember that it's normal for stress factors like pests to occasionally cause some discoloration or thin areas of the turf. But keep in mind that the goal of a turf grass manager is not to kill all pests everywhere, but to carefully monitor and deliberately manage pest populations. In doing so, they avoid unnecessary control tactics that are neither financially nor environmentally sustainable.